Hey, that was great.
Gonna run it for him.
Okay, here we go. Peggy Sue got married not long ago.
Probably one of the most impressive things that I saw was when Buddy Holly came over to England. He was on the Sunday night at the London Palladium, which is that similar to what was the show in America, the variety show?
Ed Sullivan,
yeah. And he came over with the crickets and he played live. I think he probably just did the one song, probably Peggy Sue. And he just had such an impact on me that I felt I wanted to do something like that. Here we are.
Well, I suppose that, you know, I've always been a great Buddy Holly fan and always will be till the day that I die. And the one thing that I remember about Buddy Holly and his music was that it always gave me the chance to be able to play the guitar simply, you know, because of those magic three chords, the Peggy Sue chords, the That'll Be the Day chords, and it was a great way of me learning the guitar. I could never, ever afford a Fender. That was the only thing that I had against him was, you know, why did you play a Fender? But eventually I got one. I still wish that I could play it like Buddy.
Yeah, I think Buddy proved that you didn't have to be an Adonis to be a rock star. I mean, you could be a guy from a small town, as we were, and it encouraged people like the Hollies to get up there and do it.
Well, but Graham Nash is involved in this. Graham Nash is going to come back and do some vocals on this with us.
The genesis of all this is very interesting. About 5 or 6 years ago, when the movie Peggy Sue Got Married was made, Paul Gurian, the director, called me and he said, listen, I got this, I've got permission to use this track of Buddy's that he did in New York City in 58. And I listened to it and I said, you know, boy, wouldn't it be fabulous if we could, like, overdub, you know, I'll get Phil Collins and George Harrison and Paul to play bass, and had all these grandiose plans. And, you know, just out of the desire to recognize the fact that to be able to sing with Buddy Holly would be an enormous opportunity not to be missed. For whatever reason, it didn't come down that way. And I was kind of depressed about the chance gone by. And so when Decca called me and said that they were doing this tribute album and that they would like the Hollies to do a track, and they would like specifically me to rejoin the Hollies for the one song. At the same time, I had in the back of my mind that this opportunity may have reared its head again. And so I sent, I talked to Tony and Alan and Bobby.
The magic about this track is that we actually have a tape of Buddy singing Peggy Sue Got Married, actually when he wrote it.
Technically what we did was that we EQ'd everything below the guitar and got rid of probably 85% of it, and then put his voice through this machine that he's made for dubbing movies.
So what we're doing at this particular moment, we're getting rid of the guitar that's on there, just leaving his vocal, and we're going to put our backing towards that, so it will be Buddy Holly and the Hollies, which will be fantastic.
To be able to sing with Buddy, to be able to bring his music into the present and propel it into the future is an opportunity that we just couldn't pass up. Please don't tell him, no, no, no. Don't say that I told you so. I just heard a rumor from a friend. I don't say that it's true. I'll just leave that up to you. If you don't believe, understand.
What I heard, of course the story could be wrong. She's the one I've been told, now she's wearing a band of gold. Peggy Sue got married not long ago.
As a songwriter, I think he was very underestimated. As a guitar player, I think he was underestimated. Because in a time of macho rock stars and, you know, early Elvis and Little Richard and Jerry Lee, here comes this guy that looks nothing like a rock star is supposed to look. I'm not sure, I am sure what I mean by that, and you know what I mean. You know, he, you know, he looked like a nerd. He looked like the kid next door, and I think that was a great part of his appeal. You recall a girl that's been in nearly every song. This is what I heard. Of course, the story could be wrong. She's the one I've been told. Well, she's wearing a band of gold. Peggy Sue got married not long ago. Peggy Sue got married not long ago. Peggy Sue got married not long ago. The fact that his music has lasted this long is a great, great credit to the musicianship that he had and the composing ability that he had.
A lot of people try to copy his songwriting, you know, and it didn't work. It didn't work for him. There is only one Buddy Holly, and that's it. You know, there's nothing else.